Wake that ass up.
Get up and get turned up with DeDe in the morning.
We get wild up here.
Well, everybody, Jussie Smollett.
Oh, Lord.
He handed over his phone. He handed over his phone records to the police. Well, the police handed them back. You guys, you'll never believe what they found on those records. Here we go, y'all.
Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
Hot topic.
Powered by 1-800-TRUCK-RAT.
Well, before we even get to Jussie, I can't. It's wearing me out, too, by the way. This story with Jussie is wearing me out. I can't even sleep at night. I'm like, oh, my God, is he lying? What is he doing? My God, Jussie, please. But anyway, before we get to that, on a serious note, anybody see the story about the couple in Wise County, I believe, that has been charged with child endangerment after two children were found locked in a dog kennel? Okay.
Yeah, this is crazy.
They have four kids in the house.
Four kids in the house. The parents are 24 years old. Mm. The ages of the kids are 5, 4, 3, and 1. And they said that the two oldest kids were actually locked in the kennel when police were called to the house over a domestic dispute. Mm. So the mom and the dad were fighting. Well, they said that the kids were walking around. The youngest one didn't have on any clothes. They were malnourished. They were dirty. There was dirt, feces, urine, and cats everywhere. They said it was just a horrible living conditions. There was plenty of food in the house, but it was locked up so that the kids couldn't get to it. So thank God whoever caught the police for the domestic dispute that these kids were actually found and removed from the home. So, golly.
Yeah, what do I say? I've been saying it all day today. Just because you can have kids, people, just because you are able to, don't mean you should.
Yeah, so true.
Don't mean you need to be a parent. That's the sad part about it. You know what I mean?
Kids are traumatized for life now.
Exactly.
And now they got to be put in a home, a foster care, and now they got to find a whole new life on their own. That's a damn shame.
But the fact that they were living like this and everything, you're just like, oh, my God. Mm. Let's talk Floyd Mayweather, everybody.
Cool.
So Floyd forgot that black folks were calling on a boycott of Gucci.
Oh, my God.
So from what I understand, he got caught walking inside of a Gucci store, and TMZ caught him, and he really just didn't know what the hell was going on. Now listen.
So, Gucci, you've been a long-time supporter. You still supporting after the whole controversy?
What controversy?
Yeah, I'm sure you heard, they had the blackface sweater, and, you know, a lot of prominent artists were dropping them. You know, the black.
Man, listen, I don't got nothing against nobody.
Really?
My thing is this. I support everybody. I like everybody. And my thing is this. I like to live life and do what I like to do. I'm not no follower. I do what the I want to do.
Right.
Because everybody say, wear this or don't wear this. I'm wearing what the I want to wear. I'm about to go into Gucci.
Were you disrespected at all by the whole blackface?
I'm about to go into Gucci.
All right. You know what?
He doesn't even know.
Yeah. Self-education would be great. And then you go on and talk about reading would work for him, too.
Well, first of all, we know what he's not doing.
Speaking of reading,
what?
50 Cent posted something on Instagram and said, hey, champ. Didn't you read about what Gucci? Oh, never mind.
Ah, just make
America. He said, just make America great again.
That's messed up.
That's right, because remember his reading is he struggle reads. Like, nobody's trying to laugh about it. But
No.
The money that he has, does he have a tutor yet?
No.
He's never learned how to read any better than
he can read, but it's like you said, it's the struggle read.
Oh.
Like, he's not the type that you want to do a commercial, you know, stuff like that. He's never had an endorsement because that's what
Because he can't read?
He's never had an endorsement for any type of sneaker, any athletic wear ever.
Wow, you're right. I've never seen that.
That's messed up.
Like I said, all that money, Floyd, get a tutor, dude.
Yeah, just like twice a week.
Yeah.
That's all it takes.
I mean, Fantasia did it.
She did.
She did.
And she's literate now.
She really did. Yeah. Did R. Kelly do it?
No, he didn't.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
All right, let me move on, everybody. I'm going to tell you, we have something new on this show, and I'm going to be honest with you, and I'm not glorifying anything, and I'm not mocking anybody. The only thing I'm going to tell you is that there's been a lot of folks in trouble with the law.
Yes,
a lot of folks.
A lot of people, a lot of entertainers that we know of, and because there's only one person on the show that I know of that really likes crime like that, has done a crime before.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh, really? What does that have to do? Yeah. Why do we have to keep bringing it
because
up?
That means that's why you can talk about
it. She almost caught a bit.
Oh, my gosh.
What was it? Was it offshore? Wait, what was it? What was it?
I don't know.
Fraud? Money laundering?
Money laundering.
Jay did something like that in college?
Yeah, I do a lot of money.
Yeah.
A lot of dollar bills.
Oh, my God.
We got our police blotter right now happening. Jade's going to update us on everything that's going on with all of the celebs. All right? When it involves the police. The first one is Chris Brown. I know that one, right? Chris did what?
Well, Chris actually, he had a welfare check at his house. The police went by there because he posted his actual address on Instagram. So they went by. Hey, you all right, son? Because 50 million people now have your address.
Everybody know where you live.
Everybody knows where you live now. But guess what? Chris Brown was actually okay. So shout out to Chris Brown.
Nice.
We got to talk about Mystical. Nobody knew he was actually locked up for the last 18 months. Well, he collected $3 million and he was bonded out. He was there on first-degree rape and second-degree kidnapping.
Are you serious?
Again. He has a problem. Yeah. But Mystical is now out free. $3 million bond.
Good.
Shout out. Y'all. 21 Savage is now a free man.
I clap for him. 21 Savage, I clap for him.
Shouts out to him. Also, Bill Cosby. Everybody's been wondering, how is America's dad? They moved him to general population in prison. We're all concerned.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he released a statement, and Bill Cosby said, prison is actually an amazing experience.
Are you serious?
He's making good out of bad. They said he led a mean game of freeze tag in the yard. Like, it was great.
I heard that he has stand-up comedy night, too.
He does.
He does a good 30-minute set.
And they have Jell-O Pudding Pop Day, too.
Yes, they do.
It's every Wednesday.
The fact that he said it's okay, it's amazing.
He said amazing. It's an amazing experience.
And he never walks up to anybody and says, you like to drum a pudding bop?
No.
Are we done with the police blotter?
No. I got one more. We gotta switch to music, though. I'm sorry.
Here we go.
Because we gotta talk about a thug.
A bad boy?
Jussie Smollett, y'all.
Jussie Smollett now is
Jussie
the thug.
Jussie Smollett is the biggest thug of them all because I hate to say it. Jussie, you on your way to jail.
Oh.
Jussie keeps lying. He handed over his phone.
Oh.
And the police handed it right back and was like, nah, bruh, you can't be giving me just your PDF files off the phone. We need your whole phone, like the phone, not just like your iTunes account. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, my God.
I mean, everything this dude is doing does not make sense. This story is driving everybody crazy. So I hate to say it. They gonna come for you, Jussie.
Yeah, they coming for Jussie.
Oh.
All right, thanks, Jade. I appreciate that with that blotter right there.
Wake that ass up.
Get up and get turned up with DeDe in the morning.
We get wild with it.